Hey, my name is Travis Albritton, head of content at Buzzsprout, and in this video, I'll teach you how to record high-quality, long-distance podcast interviews using SquadCast. So in this tutorial, we're going to do a couple of things. Number one, I'm going to show you what it looks like to actually do an interview in SquadCast. We'll go through the whole setup process, all the screens, and then you'll also see an interaction that I have with a special guest. So you can see what that would look like as well. But then we're also going to be grading SquadCast on a couple of criteria. The first one is ease of use. How easy is SquadCast to use both as the host and as the guest? We're also gonna be looking at the features that SquadCast has and measuring those against what you would typically expect from a long distance recording solution. We're gonna look at audio quality. So the quality of the audio files that you get from your recordings, and then also our own term, glitchiness. So we'll take all that information and put it together at the end of the video and let you know if we think that you should use SquadCast to do your long distance podcast interviews. But let's go ahead and get started by logging into SquadCast so you can see what the dashboard looks like. So when you first go to the home screen, this is what it looks like. And so if you haven't yet signed up for SquadCast, you would click this button and you can start your 7-day free trial, which is great. You can test drive it and see if it's going to be a good solution for you. But we've already created an account, so I'm going to go ahead and log in. And then this is what the SquadCast dashboard looks like when you log in. And there's three main areas. The first one is new session. So when you want to schedule an interview with somebody and you want to send them a very specific link for a time and a place for them to be able to join your remote interview, this is where you would set that up. So you can add the guest name so you know which interview you're doing. You can also set the date and the time. And then when you enter your guest email into this field, it will send them the link. So all they have to do is click on the link when the time is right and they'll jump into the SquadCast room with you. And with SquadCast, you can record up to 4 people at the same time. So that's you, your co-host, and maybe the person that you're interviewing and a special guest. 4 people right there. And SquadCast will record each person on their own separate track, which is pretty amazing. Now, this podcast section right here is just something that you can do if you want to further customize the SquadCast experience for you and your guest. So you can copy and paste your RSS feed into this field and click save, and that will bring in your podcast artwork and your podcast name. And so as your guests are coming into the room with you, they'll see that and they'll know they're in the right place. So that's a cool, just a little touch that you can do. And then the third area in the dashboard is sessions. So this is where you're going to see not only your previous sessions and the recordings that you had with each of those, but then also this reusable session up here. So once you create a new session in this section right here, it will show up down here in your sessions area. So you can keep track of how many interviews you have coming up and then also get easy access to any previous recordings that you have done. So let's say that I wanted to get these audio recordings from an interview that I did with Crystal. So I would just click on this carrot in the bottom, in the far right, and I can download these WAV files directly to my computer. And so you can very easily get those audio files whenever you need to. There's also a couple options for you when you download them. The first one is mix recordings. So this will mix all of your recordings into one audio file if that's how you choose to edit your podcast episodes. But then if you have trouble with these recordings, let's say that you download one of these files and it's corrupted somehow, you can click this Get Backups button and SquadCast will try and recover a backup file for you. And while it's not like 100% guaranteed, more often than not, they'll be able to get you a usable audio file, which is great because that's like every podcaster's worst case scenario when you do this great interview and then you lose the audio. So SquadCast really does their best to try and mitigate that. But then the session that will always be at the top of the section is the reusable session. And so that is if you're using a calendar software like Calendly to schedule your interviews. And so you have your guests applying to be on your podcast and they're reserving time slots. You can copy and paste this link into your scheduling software. So that way you don't have to worry about them getting bad links or you not showing up in the same room. So that's specifically what this is for. And if you just want to have a session that you send to all your guests, like you have an email template, then you can also use this as well. But that's it. Like that is your dashboard. Very simple, but everything that you could need. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to jump into a session here in SquadCast and show you what it looks like from the host perspective. Okay, so now you can see that I'm in what they call the green room, what SquadCast calls the green room. And so this is where you're going to make sure that everything is set up exactly how you want it before you jump into the interview. So you don't have to worry about, you know, using the wrong microphone or it not being plugged in or anything like that. And so you'll see over here on the left, everything that you can tweak and get access to. So for starters, you want to set your microphone to be correct. So we are going to be using our Rodecaster Pro, which is the audio mixer that I'm running my microphone through. And then for the output for the headphones, we're also going to be using the Rodecaster Pro because that's what I have my headphones plugged into. So what this does is it makes sure that when we're doing the interview that I'm using my right microphone, my right audio input, and the correct audio output. Because again, you never want to be stuck in a situation where you find out you're actually using your laptop's microphone the whole time. Now for your webcam, you can choose to not show your video. You totally have that option. But we are going to use our webcam. So you might notice this echo cancellation and wonder what this is about. So echo cancellation is essentially SquadCast ducking your audio. So if they notice that they're getting some echo, some reverb, meaning that the audio is playing out of the speakers and feeding back into the microphone, and you have echo cancellation turned on, then they're going to identify that and they're going to do their best to remedy that. So this is really only necessary if you're not using headphones, but everyone on your interview should be using headphones to really help cut down on that feedback and that reverb that you get. So we want to actually turn echo cancellation off. So now our page has refreshed because echo cancellation was turned off and we can continue going. Here, it shows you your location, which is a cool little feature if you just want to kind of see where people are dialing in from. It shows you the local time so you know if you're late or not to your meeting. And then also, if you have a question about anything that you see here or you're running into an issue using SquadCast and getting set up, you can click this Get Help button and you'll be able to either look through their help documents or get in touch with someone on their team. And then on the right, you can see me. So this is SquadCast showing you what the other person is going to see when they join the room. And so if you have something embarrassing in the background, you could take it out and make sure that everything is going to be kosher. But everything looks good for us. So what we're going to do now is we're going to actually join the session. And I'm going to show you what the host view looks like inside of SquadCast. So when you first jump into SquadCast, this is what it's going to look like. You're going to see a large video screen and then two toolbars. Up at the top, you have your user, and that just shows can take you right back to your dashboard. You can change from dark mode to light mode. You can get help, support docs. That's always in the top left corner on every page that you go to. Over here in the top right, you would press that red hang up button if you're ready to end the interview. And then also over here, you can open a chat. So if you want to chat with the person you're interviewing, let's say that they're having issues getting their microphone to pick up the audio and send it through SquadCast, you can chat with them directly to iron out any of those kinks and make sure that everything is good to go before you start recording. And then over here, you can make adjustments to any of the settings you made in the green room. So let's say that you want to use a different microphone, then you can do that here. You don't have to leave the room and come back. You can edit that right here. Same with your headphones, the webcam that you're using, whether you want to use echo cancellation or not. Now, this is a really cool feature that SquadCast has. They will tell you your Wi-Fi signal is strong, so you're going to get good audio. Because at the end of the day, when you're doing a remote recording, that's what matters. If you have a strong internet connection, you're going to get better audio quality for your podcast. Now, in addition to all of these fields, if you go to the bottom right, you'll notice this level meter. So this is SquadCast's way of telling you if your audio levels are good. So right now, we're basically exactly where we want to be. We are above the green, creeping up into the orange, but you don't see any red. So if you see red here, if these top dots are illuminated while you're speaking, that means you're too hot. That means you need to turn down the gain on your microphone so that you don't end up with clipping in your audio recording. As we move down to the bottom right corner, you can see the time elapsed. So this tells you how long your recording has been going on. And then you have this nice shiny record button in the middle of your screen. So when both you and the guest have chatted it up and you're ready to rock and roll with your interview, you click this record button and then you'll be able to start recording your interview. Now, in the left corner, you have this little user icon with a plus sign. If you click that, you can copy the link from this meeting and send it out. So let's say that they didn't get the email or they can't find the email and they're texting you. Well, you can just look at the link, copy it, text it to them through iMessage or send them an email or a Facebook message or anything like that. So that way they can actually get to the meeting. So that's super helpful to have that right here at your disposal. And then once we start recording, you're actually going to see this field update. So we're going to see active uploads from both myself and my guest. So you can monitor your progress. And when your podcast recording is done, your recordings will be listed there and you can download straight from the interview room to your computer. And so if you have any issues, any problems, you can do that while you're still live with your guest. So this is what the host side looks like. When you're getting ready to start your meeting and you're waiting for your guest, this is what you're going to see. So now we just need a guest. Well, hey, Carrie Ann, thanks for joining me today.
Hey, Travis, thanks for having me.
So I just explained what SquadCast looks like when you're the host, you just got into the room and you're waiting for your guest to join. But why don't you just kind of walk me through what you're seeing from the guest side?
All right, cool. So when I first clicked on the link, it opened up in the green room. And what SquadCast did was really cool in terms of little tips. It was like, please, please, please use a headphone. And then it gave, you know, that was step one. And then step two, it said to turn on the audio or join the session. And there was also a pop-up that asked if I wanted SquadCast to know my location. And I entered my name, I selected my microphone, and then I joined the session. And now we are here seeing our faces in split screen.
Very cool. And so I'm going to go ahead and hit record. And so now the audio that you're hearing is the audio that SquadCast gives you. And so you should be able to tell, like, even though we're not necessarily in the same place, you know, Carrie Ann's up in New York and I'm, you know, down in Florida, it still sounds like pretty good for being hundreds of miles away from each other.
Yes, I instantly heard the difference. It came in loud and crisp. So yeah, and also having great mics would help.
Yes, microphones are helpful if you're doing podcast interviews. And so right away, what you'll see is a couple things changed on my screen. First, the record button changed to a stop button. So it makes it very clear that you are recording. And I'm guessing, Carrie Ann, on your side, you can actually see something pop up that says that you're recording, correct?
Absolutely. I see a red recording message at the bottom, and I'm also seeing the timer at the bottom right.
Yes, I'm seeing that as well. So your guest will also know when they're being recorded. So there's no, like, are we recording or not? In addition to that, the waveform icon in the bottom left, where we get our audio files, has a little two next to it because SquadCast is now recording both of our microphones as separate tracks. And if I click on that, then you can see that they're both continuously uploading as we're doing this interview. And so when we actually finish the interview, it won't take very long for SquadCast to render out those audio files. So let's go ahead and stop the audio and then we'll see what happens. So you'll see immediately the downloads area popped up, and very quickly, I now have both audio files ready to be downloaded.
And on my end, there was a quick pop-up or alert that said that my files or my audio track was successfully downloaded. It's pretty cool. I really like SquadCast.
Awesome. Well, Carrie Ann, thank you so much for helping me with the SquadCast tutorial. I hope you have a great rest of your day.
Thank you. I'm happy to help, and you have a great day too.
So now that you've had a chance to see SquadCast in action, let's run through those four criteria that we started the video with and give SquadCast a grade. So the first criteria that we had was ease of use. How easy is it for you as the host and for your guests to jump into SquadCast and actually do the interview? And for that, we're going to give it an A. And that's because basically as soon as you get into the room, everything is set up for you. It's very intuitive, both from the host side and from the guest side. And you don't have to go and download like an extra app. You don't have to go through all these hurdles and jump through all these hoops in order to actually do the interview. You just send your guest a link, you both click the link, and you show up in the room and you do the interview. That's it. So as far as ease of use goes, we're giving SquadCast an A. Now, when it comes to the features of SquadCast, we're gonna give it a B+. And that's because it comes with a wide range of features that are gonna be super useful for you as a podcaster. You have the video component, so you can actually see your guest and establish a connection with them. You can record high quality audio with separate tracks. So when you go in to edit it later, it makes it so much easier to put out a polished, finished product. And if for some reason your file goes missing or you can't find your audio file, you can get backups from SquadCast, which is fantastic. But it's not an A because you can't record the video right now. So I know that SquadCast is planning on introducing that feature later in 2020. But as of right now, if you want to record your video and repurpose it for YouTube or social media clips or things like that, you'll need to use a separate software like ScreenFlow or QuickTime to be able to record your screen and then use that to upload to YouTube. So that's why we're giving SquadCast a B+ when it comes to the features. Now, one area that SquadCast absolutely shines is in audio quality. And that's really their main focus, is how do we get the best audio quality possible for podcast interviews? And they hit it out of the park. So SquadCast gets an A+ when it comes to audio quality. And as a podcaster, that's the thing that matters the most. Because for most of us, we're not using video to either put our podcast on YouTube or to promote it on social media. And you really just are trying to make it sound like you're in the same room with the person that you're interviewing. And so when I was on with Carrie Ann, even though we're hundreds of miles apart, the audio quality was fantastic. So if audio quality is important to you and you're doing long distance podcast interviews, definitely need to check out SquadCast. Now, when it comes to the final criteria that we're looking at, glitchiness, we're giving SquadCast a C+. That's because it's not uncommon for you to run into a minor difficulty or a hiccup while you're trying to get started, whether it's that you can't hear your guest's audio and you have to, you know, switch your headphones on and off to be able to kind of reset it, or their microphone isn't connecting, or there's an echo in the background, and so you have to turn on echo cancellation, whereas before you thought you wouldn't have to. Now, one thing that SquadCast is amazing at is being super responsive when you need help. So if you click on that help button in the top left corner while you're in the meeting with somebody, you can open a chat, start directly talking to somebody on their support team, and they are very responsive and very good at helping you get past whatever obstacles or hurdles you're encountering. I can tell you from my personal experience, anytime I've run into an issue and I open up the chat, it's solved in like 2 minutes. And so you're not having to thumb through all the help documentation, Google, like, how do I fix this in SquadCast? You don't have to worry about any of that because their support team is fantastic. So as far as glitchiness goes, because it's not exactly ironed out and perfect yet, but you get amazing customer support to help you through all those things, we're giving SquadCast a C+. So at the end of the day, would I recommend you use SquadCast for your long distance podcast interviews? Yes, I would. SquadCast is the software that I personally use when I'm doing my long distance podcast interviews. It's the one that we recommend the most to podcasters. And if you want to try out SquadCast and see if it's something that could be a really great fit for you and your podcasting needs, then I would definitely encourage you to sign up for their 7-day free trial. I mean, it's free, so there's nothing really that you're going to lose there. And you can see if it's going to be better than the solution that you're currently using to do your long distance podcast interviews. Well, that's it for today. If you are new here and you're an independent podcaster that's trying to grow your audience and potentially even make some money on the side, definitely make sure that you subscribe to the Buzzsprout YouTube channel, because every single week we're putting out new videos specifically geared on helping you as an independent podcaster reach your podcasting goals. Well, I hope this video was helpful for you. Thanks for watching it. And until next time, keep podcasting.